Joining me here in studio is Uriel Goldberg, who is the International Relations Coordinator and a paramedic at Magen David Adom. Uriel, thank you for coming in today. I'm sure it's a very, very busy day for you. Firstly, walk us through what we are seeing now. As Emily mentioned, it is still ongoing. What happens here now with this effort?
So as of last night, when we first received the call, we received the call from our teams on the field who reported there was an incident going on. Our teams were there. We already had 230 ambulances on scene before it even started. Thousands of volunteers were able to provide a very, very fast response. Once all the victims were evacuated, we kept a number of ambulances on scene to deal with the people who unfortunately were killed and to assist with the rescue operation afterwards. Now there are still, and I'm sure as you saw before, there's still people there on the mountain. We're still there to provide the medical assistance if needed. And we're now calling for the public to donate blood at any one of our emergency blood centres for those victims now.
And we are seeing some live images coming in now of these people who have remained at the scene. And Uriel, tell me, what is the situation with the phone lines? We understand there are a lot of very, very worried families trying to call their loved ones who just simply cannot get through.
When the incident occurred, there was a major pressure on the phone lines. We also had problems communicating with our teams in the field. We were using our technology and we were able to manage the incident. Each one of the hospitals has opened up a phone line for those who are worried. They can call and receive information if their loved ones are in fact in any one of those hospitals.
And tell me, what about the situation? We were hearing that a lot of children had been lost.
There were a number of children who were injured as well, and a number of children who went missing because of the nature of the incident. I don't know as of now how many haven't been found or are still lost at the moment, but I'm sure there are a few still.
And tell me, how long can we expect this rescue operation to continue?
The rescue operation will end once everyone has left the mountain. So once all those visitors have left and we're able to safely make sure there's no one else left at the site, we'll be able to close up and say that's it. Because we're now coming into Shabbat, Saturday, it may be a bit of a problem, it may take a little bit longer.
All right, and we were seeing some other images coming through regarding a blood drive happening at Rabin Square in Tel Aviv. Just tell me, what is the situation there?
We have a number of blood drives across the country. These are emergency blood drives. We were low on blood anyway, blood supplies anyway, before the incident. We need as many people as possible to come and donate blood in any one of the major cities. They can look on the MDA website for the locations. And we need as many people to come and to donate blood.
All right. And we know that 44 people, unfortunately, were killed, many more injured. Walk us through some of these injuries. We know some are in a critical condition still.
Yes. Yeah, so right on the first moment, the first thing which we heard about, and those who were injured were actually those who were unconscious and unfortunately not breathing with no pulse. There were bystanders and medics who were performing CPR on them. As the event unfolded, we saw that some of the injuries were critical head injuries, serious crush injuries, and obviously broken limbs, due to the nature of the incident.
And from what emergency services were seeing, we know that last year this event was cancelled, of course, due to coronavirus. These pictures are showing just so many people converging on such a tight space. Does it look like this may have, you know, been busier than last year?
It was definitely busier than last year. I don't know, I think it wasn't as busy as years beforehand, but it was busier than last year and it was too many people, obviously.
All right, Uriel Goldberg, we really appreciate your time. Thank you so much for coming in.